Hi, it's Dan Veal here, and welcome back to my basement in Guitar Interactive magazine. We have the absolutely superb Fender Nick Mendel Precision here in for review, and it's absolutely wicked candy apple red. First up, I should definitely say a big thank you to DV247, a brilliant shop here down in Romford. Check out their absolutely brilliant line of Fender basses online through their online store. They've been absolutely great, so thank you very much for the loan of these basses. Right then, let's get on. We have essentially a copy of a 1971 Precision bass, as owned by Nick Mendel from the Foo Fighters. So this is a signature model, but aside from being a signature model, it's just a really nice bass. So I've been having a bit of a zoom around on it before we started recording. And it feels quite familiar because I'm actually quite a fan of like the 70s, what they call A-neck, around 40, 41 millimeter nut width on a Fender bass. So this one actually feels quite comfortable straight off bat. So anyway, let's get up to the old headstock as we always do, and we'll zoom across the instrument. Have a little bit of a blast around it and see what you think of the sounds. So we have a typical script logo here. Okay. And the usual elephant ear tuning keys. I'm gonna flip the bass over. You know what they look like anyway, but I'll show you anyway. So here we go. Over on this lovely maple neck, around we go. Nice Fender keys. Signature, very nice. Okay. Made in Mexico, this particular model. And you can see already it's, it looks like it's been a glossy neck, but it's been kind of satined down a little bit. It's almost kind of road worn kind of feel and look about it, which I think is really, really cool. Slightly it's off yellowed, like it's had years and years of service. And speaking of which, yeah, there's some road worn markings on it, shall we say, to make it look like it's been aged a bit. So if I carry on turning the bass around, have a look at the bottom of the headstock. You can see a few little dings in there. So I'll just turn it down for you. Yeah. A little, hopefully you can see those on the camera. Just looks like it's been in and out of the case a few times. And the same for the tuning keys as well, actually. They're kind of not all nice and glossy and shiny. They also look like they've seen a few gigs and a bit of sweat, blood and tears. Okay, moving down the fretboard then. So, as I said before, the nut on this particular model, it's like an A neck, as we call it. 41 millimeters on this. 40, 41, you know, spitting hairs. Really nice, comfortable feel about it. The profile is nice and skinny, not a million miles away from a jazz bass, but just a little bit more wood on it. So a nice kind of in-betweeny size, and I really like that. It feels really good, really nice and comfortable. Rosewood fretboard, of course. Ping the neck over and some nice little small black dots markers on top. And then back again, markers in the usual places on the fretboard as well. There we go. Now this is quite a light rosewood on this one, actually. Kind of looks like it's hit the sun a bit, I suppose. It's kind of lightened up. Maintaining that sort of road-worn sort of look. Coming down the neck, I notice it doesn't feel like they're like rolled or smoothed fret edges. I mean, they're not hurting, they're not sharp, but they definitely, you can tell they're there basically. So I don't know, my own kind of stickler for detail, I'd probably want to soften those out a little bit. Coming down the neck, onto the body, candy apple red. I love it, it's great. I've wanted a kind of candy apple red P bass for quite a long while. So this one's, you know, winning awards already. Look at that, really nice. And again, some nice little dings and marks on this. This might not be your cup of tea, but actually, I don't know, it kind of suits this bass. Flipping over, I'll go around the edge and you can see some, like, you know, sort of little markings here and some little dents and things. And the whole body looks like it's, I don't know, almost had like a fine scouring pad taken to it. You know, the finish is not that lovely, glossy, shiny red. So, F plate. So, usual string, neck mounting, as it were. Back over, meow, like so. Right, black pickguard, so typical 70s style pickguard. Master volume and tone control jack. Nice big high mass bridge. So looks a bit like the old Badass bridges, I suppose. This is Fender's version. It is only top loading, so no through body. Nice big chunky piece of metal, and actually you can hear it acoustically. The bass does have a nice bit of chunky ring to it. Picked up by split coils. This is the SPB3, Seymour Duncan's P bass pickup on steroids. Lots and lots of punch, lots and lots of volume from that. You know, equally as powerful as a bass that we had with Active Electronics earlier on for review. So that's nice and meaty as well. We'll have a little listen to the tone control. We'll buzz that around so you can hear what the bass is capable of. Excellent. Okay. Oh, and then finally, I forgot to mention, the body is ash. So unlike, you know, older or maybe like basswood of some of the other models, nice big chunky bit of ash as well. But that said, this particular example is not really heavy. This is actually fairly comfortable, actually. I could do a 2-hour gig with this with no problem, and I've got a bad back, so it should be okay. Right, let's have a listen. So I did a bit of pick work on the intro. Tone control was all the way open. A bit of finger style, and the action's a little bit high on this particular example. I'll do a bit of slap work, see what happens. Here we go. So let's take that tone control back a little bit, so go halfway around the travel. Here we go. And then all the way off, so this is no top end. Yeah, really nice, actually. So I just zoomed through the control and just found some nice settings, all the way open for some nice top-end harmonics. And the pickup actually does a really nice job of giving you a nice rounded kind of harmonic sound rather than boosting loads of treble on an active circuit, for example. So that's really, really tasty. And then back, as soon as we rolled the control off, you got that lovely mellow, you know, I did a very bad Motown impression there, just sort of zooming around a bit of finger style. But I think it suit that really nicely as well. So you've got these nice attacking rock sounds, maybe add a bit of drive to it from a valve amp or a good distortion pedal, but the same token being able to round it off and have some really classic P-bass sounds. The more I play this, the more I really like it. It just feels comfortable. And as I said, I'd probably want to bring the action down a little bit for myself. But that said, I think there's nothing else you can really change about it. It's just a really cool, very nice bass. So, Mexican made Fender Nate Mendel Precision in Candy Apple Red. What else can I tell you? Obviously 20 frets, 7.25 inch radius on the fretboard. So familiar feeling, rosewood fretboard and a lacquer finish. There we go. Nate Mendel, thank you very much. Excellent bass. Check out the written review as well. And of course, I will catch up with you again very, very soon. Thanks ever so much for watching.